stand with us. And let's, if you don't mind, we'll begin with a word of prayer, and then if you will remain standing and join us in the pledge to the flag. Let's bow together. Father, we glorify your name. Thank you for this day, for the blessings that it holds. Thank you for this opportunity to gather together and conduct the business of our county, and we ask that you direct us in all that we do. Bless those that are here in attendance today, in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Join me in the pledge, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We are thrilled to see all of you here today. It's good to have a good crowd in the commission meeting. Appreciate your interest in the business of the commission. We are especially thrilled to see a number of students with us today. So I'm going to call on Commissioner Kyle Adams to introduce the guests that are with us from the schools and tell about those, and I think we have some presentations to make as well.
Okay, first off, we'll start with the Red Level Peer Helper Group. The sponsor is my wife, Tori Adams, and she has 8 students with her here today, and she's going to present a program. The students are going to present a program about recycling to the commission. Okay. We'll let them go first, then I'll introduce the other ones.
Who was your bus driver today, Tori?
Well, I was the bus driver.
Okay, well.
But we had fun getting here, huh?
Well, we're just glad you made it.
Yeah, all together.
And they were too.
Yeah.
Everybody have a seat.
And Mr. McGlon, our principal, is with us. He's been very supportive of all of our efforts this year and allowing us to come out and present this to you today. So thank you, Mr. McGlon. He has a lot of patience. Yes.
Okay. Good morning. First, I would like to thank you all for passing the half-cent sales tax for education. We know this will benefit us all greatly. Today we are here to present our recycling program to you. The RLHS Peer Helpers have noticed a serious campus problem that we need your help to solve.
And you all have a presentation that Jacob and Sydney made in preparation for today to share with you.
So some of y'all might know the whole definition of pollution. Pollution is the presence in or introduction in the environment of a substance or thing that has harmful or poisonous effects. Most common types of pollution are air pollution, water pollution, agricultural pollution, and land pollution. The effects of pollution is preventable, and students can help reduce it. Pollution negatively impacts everything from the air we breathe to the water we drink. Pollution has been linked to numerous diseases and complications. Some top 10 facts about pollution. The first one is pollution is one of the biggest killers, affecting more than 100 million people worldwide. Fact number 2 is more than 1 billion people worldwide do not have access to safe drinking water. Number 3, 5,000 people die every day due to drinking unclean water. Number 4, the garbage dumped in the ocean every year is roughly around 14 billion pounds. Plastic is mainly all of it. Number 5, people who live in high-density air pollution areas have 20% higher risk of dying from lung cancer than people living in less polluted areas. Number 6, the United States produces 30% of the world's waste and uses 25% of the world's natural resources. Number 7, more than 3 million kids under the age of 5 years old dies each year due to pollution. Number 8, China is the world's largest producer of carbon dioxide, with the United States number 2. Number 9, Antarctica is the cleanest place on Earth due to anti-pollution laws. Number 10, composting and recycling alone has prevented 85 million tons of waste to be dumped in 2010 alone. So what we're doing, the Red Level Peer Helpers, is trying to start a recycling program at our school and local county schools. Our goal is to sort our waste in recycling bins so the waste can get to the appropriate sites instead of going to a landfill. Why we need a recycling program? Schools throw away 80% of recyclable goods. The 80% of recyclable goods will help raise funds for the school. It is 36% cheaper to have recycling bins than trash cans. And our little quote thing is, recycle the present to save the future. Thank you.
Presentation. You guys have questions for them, or do some of the rest of you that haven't spoken want to make comments? You're welcome to.
Anybody? Look like they all want to say something.
I know, they talk all the way over here.
Know how to get them quiet. We do. I want to thank y'all for having this interest in, you know, your environments and what goes on around you, and as far as just waste, you know, trash that gets thrown out and stuff, and trying to do something with it. That means a lot. It means that you do take care. I have pride in your area you live in your county, in your country. So that means a lot.
I know you said, Tori, that you're talking to the school board about this, about with other schools. What about the city schools within the?
Kevin can speak on Andalusia's. He's actually talked with them. They had implemented one last year.
They did, and it was not successful. And they didn't tell me. They just said it was not successful, that so much stuff was thrown in there, they didn't have the personnel. And what I like about Tori's presentation is these students have agreed to make sure that this is done properly. I don't know. Andalusia didn't tell me what happened exactly. They just said that they tried it, and it didn't work because of the enormous amounts of drinks and stuff that was left in the bottles and cans put in there, because the cans actually need to be emptied and the bottles need to be emptied.
Yeah.
And that's where this group that has agreed to make sure that that's done correctly, I believe, is going to make the difference. But that's what Andalusia told me. They tried it and it did not work.
So they still recycle. I can speak. My brother is the public works director for the city, and he's over that.
The city recycles as a whole.
Yeah, they still recycle, but they collect all the bags, and I think they're sent to their process plant, I think in Mobile. Hmm. Or Pensacola, and that's where they're actually taken there, and that's where they actually separate the recyclables.
Right.
Well, and our goal would be to work out all the kinks. Once we knew that the commission would help us with sponsoring the cans and the bags, then we would like to implement it in the next school year and have a plan with the other schools. Like, they would need to know, hey, we need you to stand with these, you know, containers during the break time period and make sure. And we sell break anyway during the day, like the beta club members do. So we have a rotating schedule of who will be out there working, so we can make sure that, you know, people are there. It could probably, that was a good point, though. It could be an issue during the day at other times, so we may need to, like, remove the cans or put them somewhere else. But that's kind of where we are. We definitely want to have it happen, but we want to make sure we have everything in line before we proceed forward.
Want it to succeed, don't you? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Well, the commission can certainly help them jumpstart this.
The biggest need was, and I've already spoken with Lynn about it, was the transportation of the material from each school to the recycling place. Lynn has said that they could do it once a week, but I'm not sure that all schools would need it once a week, maybe every other week for for some of those?
It's probably going to be, like, initially, I know it probably be trial and error, to see if bi-weekly was enough or if every week.
And
probably a bigger school like Strawn, it would be
once
more
a
weekly,
week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But he said the trash crew that we currently have is around a school mm-hmm. each week, so it wouldn't be out of the way to go
okay.
pick it up.
Good.
So.
What about cans?
The cans, Kevin has looked at the prices, and it would be $633, would provide 10 cans and the bags needed to start the program.
But I would like to say this, I was telling Kevin earlier, we might be able to get the cans cheaper because that's an awful lot of money for the cans. And mm-hmm. I know, I've just found out about a program with Pepsi, and I wanted to bring my materials this morning, but I forgot my password. My husband will understand my struggle on me forgetting stuff. But anyway, Pepsi has what's called a Recycle Rally program that they partner with schools, and they even provide incentives. Like, sometimes they'll purchase the cans for the school. They give money back to the school for participating in recycling efforts, and we're all, am I correct in saying this, we're all Pepsi schools in the county, correct? So we would all benefit from that. I know whenever I signed us up, we showed up in the system, and if they decide to make a video about their school and their recycling efforts, they even just for making the video, they send $200 to the school. And if you win, you get like $1,000. I mean,
yeah.
Stuff that they already know how to do.
So maybe the maximum out-of-pocket on our side would be $750,
mm-hmm.
and then maybe something less if you're successful in
yes.
getting
yes.
these other sponsors.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else have questions or comments on that?
No.
Kyle, you want to make a motion that we have?
Yes, I'll make a motion that we enter into this partnership.
Up to $750?
Up to $750.
Okay. And that will help you with the transportation. Is there a second?
Tony.
Second. Questions, comments?
I just think it's a good thing, and I hope maybe the other schools, like you said, see what's going on and we can help them participate as well.
Yeah.
We thank you for your support very much, for even hearing this.
Well, we appreciate you taking a lead on it. Next step is to help us with roadside litter, so we'll talk about that.
I agree.
Okay. We do have a motion and a second. If there's nothing else, we'll vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries, so we'll help you with the funding. Thank you guys for being here today. And,
thank you, ladies.
If y'all will hang with us just a few minutes, we have another presentation that Kyle's going to lead us in, and then we'll take a recess, and there'll be some pictures and stuff, and you guys can get back to class, which is first priority.
That's what they're ready to do.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Kyle.
All right, next we have Coach Trent Taylor, Ethan Wilson, Bridges Anderson, and Roosevelt Weaver from Andalusia High School. Come on up. And it may take a few minutes. We have four proclamations to read, but I'll start with this one.
Why don't you stand over here just like they did in the line of fire.
The first one says, whereas Bridges Anderson, a student of Andalusia High School, was recognized by the Alabama Sports Writers Association in Class 4A, first team All-State for 2017. And whereas his efforts as a receiver led to him being a part of this All-State team, and whereas he is to be commended for an exciting, hard-fought, and successful year, and you should rightly take pride in your accomplishments and the record you earned, and whereas it gives us a tremendous amount of pleasure to express to Bridges on behalf of the Covenant County Commission and all the citizens of Covenant County our sincere congratulations on achieving innumerable successes and accomplishments, and our appreciation for your demonstration for your peers and all of us in your community that great accomplishments can be realized with hard work, perseverance, practice, and commitment. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that the Covenant County Commission is pleased to publicly commend Bridges Anderson for his fine efforts and to present this proclamation as an expression of the admiration of the Commission and all of our citizens to Bridges Anderson. Adopted and approved this 13th day of February.
Did you want to make an acceptance speech or anything?
Also, something that stands out with Bridges is he just signed a letter of intent to play football for Vanderbilt. So that's a great thing also. The second one is, whereas Ethan Wilson, a student of Andalusia High School, was recognized by the Alabama Sports Writers Association in Class 4A, second team All-State for 2017, and whereas his efforts as quarterback led him to being a part of this All-State team. And whereas he is to be commended for an exciting, hard-fought, and successful year, and you should rightly take pride in your accomplishments and record you earned. I'm not going to read all of it because the next three paragraphs are the same as the first one. So this is adopted and approved this 13th day of February 2018. Whereas Roosevelt Weaver III, a student of Angelusia High School, was recognized by the Alabama Sports Writers Association in Class 4A honorable mention for 2017, and whereas his efforts as running back led him to being given this recognition, and whereas he is to be commended for an exciting, hard-fought, successful year, and you should rightly take pride in your accomplishments and record you earned. Adopted and approved 13th day of February 2018.
Coach, you want to make comments?
I would be glad to.
We'll give you the microphone.
First of all, two of these three are seniors, so Roosevelt and I are going to make a very, very good mental picture because it may be a long time before we get to do this again. But obviously, we stood here last year with a couple of guys. I'm very, very proud of all three of these guys. I can't believe they don't want to talk. They talked about them well here. I hope they got an opportunity to do that. the biggest thing, obviously, these guys are very, very good athletes.
Thank you guys for being
Thank
here.
You
and we have one more.
All right. Good.
Also, Ethan just recently signed a letter of intent to play baseball at South Alabama, and next year we'll look forward to the same thing
Watching
from Roosevelt.
The Jaguars play.
But on the team one, it says, whereas Andalusia High School football team experienced a successful 2017 season, advancing to the Alabama High School Athletic Association semifinals for the second consecutive season. Whereas you're to be commended for an exciting, hard-fought, and successful season, and you should rightly take pride in your accomplishments of the team and the records you earned, as well as the life experiences gained from participation within your teammates and coaches in this achievement. And whereas it gives us a tremendous amount of pleasure to express to all members of the Andalusia High School football team and coaching staff, on behalf of the County Commission and all the citizens of Covenant County, our sincere congratulations on achieving innumerable successes and accomplishments, and in doing so, demonstrating for your peers and all of us in your community that great accomplishments can be realized with hard work, perseverance, practice, and commitment. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that Covenant County Commission is pleased to publicly commend the Andalusia High School football team for their fine efforts and to present this proclamation as an expression of the admiration of this commission and all the citizens of the members of this team. Adopted and approved this 13th day of February 2018. We do have one more student that was unable to be here from Florella, Jacob Hammack, and we'll try to get him here and recognize him at a later date. He was 1A All-State second team, I believe is what it was.
All right. The commissioners want to make comments about these presentations before we take a recess?
We thank y'all for your hard work. Just didn't happen overnight. Y'all had to really do what you had to do. Practice and stay focused, and we just want you to continue that through the rest of your life because you see what you can do now, and so you see there's no limit to what y'all can do, and it means a lot to our county for y'all what having these accomplishments as well.
Anyone else?
Well, I appreciate what y'all are doing representing the school and the county, and hopefully when you go on to college, you'll maintain the same perseverance as you've had and be successful in that and represent your family and your community the way you have in the past.
If there's nothing else, we want to take a recess for 10 minutes, and that'll give us a chance to speak to you guys, peer helpers. Thank y'all so much for being here. We're recessed for 10 minutes.